Till death Some to the part of the ceremony where we exchange rings. Michael, place the ring on Amy's left hand and repeat after me. With this ring I thee wed, and with all my worldly goods I thee endow. In the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Ghost.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
And repeat after me. Amy, with this ring I thee wed, and with all my worldly goods I thee endow. In the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Ghost. In the book of Genesis we read, and the Lord caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof. And the rib which the Lord God had taken to man made he a woman and brought her unto the man. And Adam said, this is now bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh, and she shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother and cleave, and shall cleave to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. Okay, I want to take a moment to just say a prayer right here. Y'all would bow your heads with me. Heavenly Father, just thank you for this day. Just thank you for Michael and Amy and their commitment to one another, to be coming here and to share this ceremony between you and all their friends. And I pray that your grace and mercy will just be shed upon them all the days of their lives, and they shall honor you with their lives. In Jesus Christ's name, amen.
Amen.
Marriage is the clasping of hands, the blending of hearts, the union of two lives as one. Your marriage must stand, not by the authority and license of this day, nor by the words of me as a minister, but by the strength of your love and the power of faith in each other and in God. It should never be said of either of you that you show more concern for a friend than you do for each other. More kindness, gentleness, and concern needs to be shown in the privacy of your home than anywhere. Indeed, your home should be a haven from all the confusion and craziness this world has to offer. The Word of God is clear about what it means to love, and we read that in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, and it reads this: love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. Love does not rejoice in the wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things, and most of all, love never ends. In the words of Jesus, love one another. In closing, those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder. For as much as Michael and Amy have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God and all these people here, and by the same, by giving and receiving a ring, I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Michael and Amy, may you always need one another, not so much to fill the emptiness as to help each other know fullness. May you want one another, not out of lack. May you embrace one another, but not encircle one another. May you succeed in all important ways with each other, and not fail in little graces, but look for things to praise. Often say I love you, and take no notice of small faults. May you have happiness, and may you find it in making one another happy. May you have love, and may you find it in loving one another. You may now kiss the bride.